Hey guys, so I just got back from riding the trails on the snowmobile. Oh my god. Well, as you guys already saw.
Hi.
Hi. You gonna say hi? You say hi? Snot nose? He's trying to see. Yeah, okay, hang on, let daddy sit down. Alright, so real quick, I'll explain what happened. I went out without even looking over my sled. I just kind of like, okay, well, it runs, so it's got to be good, right? Nope. I get out there, and and let's see. First off, my skis are bent, and so that was a whole adventure in itself. I was just all over the freaking map on the trails. It was so bad. Okay, hold on. Sorry, guys. Oh, God. Daddy's arm is so sore. Ugh. All right. There. Okay. So, I decided I would only go over to John's, right? And even before John's, there's a trail that goes right behind his daughter's place. And I was going to go over to their house and visit. Well, what happened was, as you guys saw in the video, I got massively stuck. And I'm not talking like, oh, you know, real simple. Pull it out, no big deal. No, it was my camera, actually, my battery died while I was trying to get the snowmobile out. And I was out there about 45 minutes trying to get the snowmobile out of, because I made a stupid mistake. Excuse me. I tried to turn around and drive to this kind of marsh area, not realizing that the snow was hip deep. I'm not kidding, guys. It was hip deep. It was, and I'm 5'8", so that was like 3 feet, 3.5 feet deep. And my hand's getting sore. And so then I'm like, okay, well, at first I was like, okay, this is gonna be no big deal, right? Then I get off the sled and I sink down in the snow and I'm like, I panic started setting in. I'm like, oh my god, you know, how am I gonna do this? My left arm is my bad arm, and I gotta keep the snowmobile running, and it doesn't idle, so I gotta keep feathering the throttle. Well, by the time I realized that it ain't gonna happen, you know, with one arm, I'm just gonna have to let it die on me and hope to God it starts back up again. So I was literally lifting and then digging and then lifting and digging. And I go to the front and I reef on the skis and I try and pick up the front end, which I can't do. I can't pick up the front end hardly at all. And it was just hell. And about half an hour, not even, maybe 15 minutes into it, I was working so hard that I thought my heart was going to explode. And I shit you guys not, I thought that was the end of me. I legitimately laid down, texted Amanda and told her, honey, I love you. Give the kids kisses for me and tell them their daddy died doing what he loved, you know? And Amanda, what's going on? What's going on? She texted me back. I didn't expect her to text me back right away. And I'm just like, I'm stuck. I'm so stuck. And my heart is literally racing so fast that I think my heart's gonna explode. And she's like, you need to calm down, just sit down. So I kind of fell back into the snowdrift and just sat there for about 25 minutes and just laid there. And I mean, I had my helmet on, so it sounded like Darth Vader, you know? I was like, it was just hell. So I laid there for a little while, finally started to calm down, my heart started to slow down a little bit, and I'm 40 years old, I'm not a young pup anymore, you know, I mean, heart attack is a real thing right about now, plus that my triglycerides are really high from cheese, of all things, and, so I was a little concerned, and, after about, like I said, about a half an hour, I got back up. And I motivated myself to just go back and do it again. So I lifted it up, moved it, lifted it up, moved it. I finally turned the whole sled around and had it facing the way I came in. So now I'm back on the trail, on my snowmobile trail, so there's no more resistance. You know, with the front skis and that. And I don't know, maybe Dad was out there, but my snowmobile started again without giving it fuel in the carburetor, in the cylinder. And I got it out. And I was going to drive over to Janalee's, which is my friend John's daughter. But there was no easy way to get there. And I'm like, screw it, I'm just going to drive all the way to John's, which is about 3 miles. I got to John's, and I'm like, and I'm just dripping sweat. I'm like, I need to lay down. I said, my heart is just, and it was still really, you know, really going. And I was shaking, dramatically shaking, you know. So I laid down, I took off my stuff, my bibs and my jacket and hat and everything. And I laid there for about an hour. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm a little tired. And now I'm like, all right. Me and John went to Marshfield and got done whatever we need to get done in there. And I'm like, okay, well, I'm going to go. I was feeling fine now. You know, it was about 2 hours later. I'm like, well, we got back to John's place. I'm like, all right, I'm going to head home. And I wasn't going to take the trail I already took. I was going to go all around and get back. You know, anyway, so the trail was absolute hell. All the way home, it was absolute hell. It was drift upon drift upon drift. It wasn't groomed. And the carburetor or the fuel filter was plugged. And so I was constantly going from choke to half choke to no choke, back to half choke, back to no choke. Because it was bogging down, and so something was happening. I can't just pull over because I'm afraid it won't start back up again. But I made it back by the skin of my teeth. I made it home. It was an adventure. My arm is about done for the month, I would guess. And I will say this though, I figured out how to start it pretty easily. Simply, I just, I just pull the choke wide open, and I pull it until it fires, and then, once it fires, then I full choke, or, shut the choke off, and give it full throttle. You okay? You're okay. And it starts right up. So, I don't even know if I have to put gas in the cylinder anymore. So, that's good. And this little man is just crazy. You're a crazy little dude. What are you doing? Daddy's arm is really sore. You're gonna pull it right out of socket. Yeah. Yeah, you gotta be careful with that arm. Please be careful. Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. You wanna see? I got an owie. You wanna see Daddy's other owie? I burnt myself making bratwurst. Check this out. It's a nice little... Oh, you okay? A nice little blister I got there. Gonna kiss my boo-boo? See it? Oh, it's right there. See the blister? See that? Kiss it. Bah! Yeah. No, there's no always. Just Daddy's arm is sore. No, that's just old. Now John wants to get a sled and go riding. Well, I don't think I want to ride anymore, to be perfectly honest. I laid on a bitch fest on Facebook, too. Because I know a lot of people that are involved with snowmobile trails. And so I thought I'd just throw it out there in general direction of those people that are in the snowmobile clubs. Because Wisconsin started this new thing where they... Now you have to pay for a trail pass and a registration. And that's, if you're not a member, it's $30 for that trail pass. If you are a member, it's only $10. So that's still an extra $10. But then the registration is $40. So for me to have my sled legal on the trails, it's $70. Now, I understand the registration, but I don't get the trail pass. I think it's just another gimmick they're doing just so we can have to pay the state for something that's never going to happen. I mean, the trails today, you know, sure, we pay $30 for this trail pass. Guess what? We had a snowstorm 3 days ago, and nothing. There has not been one groomer on those trails. I literally bounced all the way home. I might as well have been Frogger. I mean, it was constant drift jumping all the way. And that's no kidding. That's like, I want to say, 10 miles the roundabout way to get back to this house. And let me tell you, it takes a toll on you and the machine. I mean, my back is, it's not so bad. It was bad before. But my shoulders are just, you know, terrible. And had I been, a bit older, like John's age, and been on the snowmobile trails, I would have had to stop or turn around or I don't even know. I mean, it was that bad. I'm talking like 3 foot high drifts every 3 feet.
You're nuts. Yeah. You got a car? Let me see your cars. Can you show them your cars? Where is it? Wow. Those are cool, buddy. What kind are they? This one is... Oh, it's just a Hot Wheels truck. Let me see the other one. I bought these for him a little while ago. Is that a grave? Oh, that's a grave digger. See? I can't really tell. Yeah, right there. It says grave digger on it. If it'll focus. There we go. I don't know. Yeah. Oh no! Huh? Oh no! So that's my bitch fest for the riding the trails today. It was bullshit. I suppose it would have been better had I had a new machine. But, you know, I'm just pissed off they charged that trail pass. That really bothers me. Because, like I said, I threw it out on Facebook and I'm like, who the hell thinks they can, you know, just throw out a new fee and make it harder for us to enjoy the trail systems? And then here we spend all this money just to be able to legally ride on the trails and they're not even groomed. 3 days has been since our snowstorm. Why has nobody groomed the trails? So, yeah. And I got a couple comments back saying, oh, join the club. Oh, join the club. Boy, I have joined the club. I've joined 3 different clubs, I think. And, I mean, sure, I want to volunteer. When I was in these clubs, I wanted to volunteer to help out. But you got to be at a certain stature before you can drive the groomer. You can't just join a club and drive the groomer. So how am I helping? You know, I'm just joining the club. And there I am. That's it. You know, I'm not doing anything. I got to be in a club like 3 years before I can even drive a groomer. And I tell you what. If anybody would be out there driving a groomer, it would be me because I'm not working. Why not have me do this, you know? So I think I'm going to look into it. But if I decide I'm going to join a club, I'm going to be like, listen, I'll join a club, but I want to drive the groomer right away. I want to be able to help out immediately. I don't want to have to wait and be a member for a certain amount of time before I can actually prove my worth, you know? So. Yeah. Isn't that right, bud? Where are you? Oh, you're beating daddy up. Ah. No, don't bite. Don't bite. Don't bite. Ow. Ouch, Jack. Don't bite. No, don't lick. Stop licking. You're gross. You're gross. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. I'm going to get that tongue. Oh no. Don't die. You're okay. Get up. Get up. Stand up. Silly boy. Are you a silly boy? Hey, come back here. He's being really goofy. Come here, Jack. Back. Come here. Show him you can fight. Stick him up. Ready? Get me. Hey-ya. Oh, no. Oh. Come on. You're dead. I shot you first.
He just beats me up. Sorry about the quality of this.
No, don't lick. Stop licking. He's trying to lick me. Help, he's trying to lick.
What is it with you and licking? I don't get it.
No.
Ah! You're gross. You're gross. Don't lick me.
Yeah, now you got something on your mouth. There you go. Stop it.
All right, before I get licked to death,
would you clear it off, you little shit? I'll beat you.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Little punk. Little punk. What's the matter? He can't. No. Oh, you tricked me. He licked me. You tricked Daddy. Yeah. Can you give them a kiss goodbye? Oh, thank you. Bye.
Bye, guys. See you on the next one. Thanks for watching.